Ladies and gentlemen, your host for Come Dancing, Rosemary Ford.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Group A semi-final of our International Come Dancing series for the Marshall Amplification Trophy. The Group A semi-finalists are all behind me, so please welcome first the team who beat Northern Ireland in round one, and they are the Czech Republic. And in opposition, the team who earlier knocked out Lithuania, and they are England. As always, the Latin section opens our program, and the first dance is a samba, and stepping out for the Czech Republic, it's Karol Bank and Leona Švardalová. Well, for England, it's Matthew Cutler and Nicole Westay. Joining me with all the competitors' details is Charles Nove. And to conduct our orchestra up there on stage, none other than Andy Ross.
Bank and Leona Svardalova have been dance partners for the last 7 years. He's a 28-year-old student, she's an economist aged 27. Karol fills his non-dancing moments designing dance costumes, including the one his partner's wearing now. They've won the Czech Republic's Latin Championship twice. Cutler and Nicole Westdyke opening the account for England tonight. Nicole's part Dutch, part South African, and on a working visit last year, they won the South African Latin Championship. The early part of this year saw them finish fourth in the UK Championship open to the world. And next year, we'll see them back in South Africa, a social call this time, to get married.
Dance to that old favorite, Copacabana. Our second Latin dance tonight is the rumba, the dance of love. And here competing for the Czech Republic are René Ostarek and Bronislava Vratolova. And for England, welcome Paul Richardson and Lorna Dawson.
René Ostarek and Bronislava Vratalova are 24 and 22, and they rank as their country's second-placed Latin couple. Abroad in their 2 years as partners, they've won the Mid-European Latin Cup twice.
They warm and excite us.
closed British amateur Latin champions, Paul Richardson and Lorna Dawson. They're 23 and 24, are number one representatives in world ranking competitions abroad, and currently ranked sixth in the world. Paul's native country is Australia, and recently they competed in the Australian Championship, finishing second in both the Latin and the modern sections.
And that brings us to our first judging in this contest. So let me introduce you to our panel of judges, who are the former amateur Czech Republic modern and pen dance champion, Tony Zmoran. And it's a welcome back to Come Dancing to former All England old-time champion, Julie Earnshaw. And acting as our neutral judge, the former Soviet Latin and modern dance champion, now from Lithuania, Juraka Novaisha. Now, the first dance in our Latin section was the samba. So can we have your comments and your collective marks for that, Tony Zmoran?
Yes, Rose. The Czech couple was very expressive, very entertainment, and he has very great potential. The English couple used very good body rhythm, had very good balance, and so we decide collective marks, 2 points for England, 1 point for Czech Republic.
Thank you. And now, Julie Earnshaw, could we have your collective marks for the rumba?
Yes, in the rumba, I thought the couple from the Czech Republic danced with a good style, and it was nice to see them incorporating some of the basic figures, such as the fan, into their routine. However, I felt the couple from England danced with a more controlled leg action, and our collective marks are the Czech Republic 1 point and England 2 points.
Thank you very much. Thank you. So after our first section, the Czech Republic have 2 and England have 4. Well, our modern competitors are now standing by for their 2 dances. And we start with the foxtrot, a dance which incidentally originated in America just before the First World War. It was one of those many dances with animal names like the turkey trot and the horse trot. And the foxtrot was allegedly created by a Ziegfeld Follies comic called Henry Fox. So let's meet the competitors. And here are Tomáš Heller and Dagmar Novoharadská competing for the Czech Republic. And for England, here are Christopher Hawkins and Hazel Newberry.
Tomáš Heller is 24 and his partner Dagmar Novoharadská is 21. They're both full-time students. Tomáš studies at the Dance Conservatoire, Dagmar at the Law Faculty. In their 18 months of dance partnership, they've reached 4th place in the Czech Modern Championship. Hawkins and Hazel Newberry have been partners for 3 years, and they've been busy years of competition, climbing steadily up the ladder. In most of their big events of the last year, they finished in 2nd place. At this year's Open British Championship, it was third place, but excellent news from a recent contest in Copenhagen. It was open to the world, and Chris and Hazel won.
Dance to What Now My Love. A change of tempo now for our second modern dance, the waltz. And here competing for the Czech Republic are Jaroslav Harvan and Jitka Havanova. And for England, we have Timothy Howson and Joanne Bolton.
Jaroslav Harvan and Jitka Havanova are both 30, and away from the dance floor, he's a doctor, she's a nurse. Jaroslav and Jitka got together as dance partners 15 years ago, and eventually became husband and wife as well. They've danced in European and world competitions, and they've won their country's modern championship title four times. Timothy Howson and Joanne Bolton are 24 and 22, and they've just reinforced their position as our top amateur modern dancers with a third successive win of the Open British Championship. They're also European, American, and international champions, and at last year's World Contest, they were runners-up.
Judges to be in the limelight now as they give us those all-important marks. The first of our two modern dances tonight was that fabulous foxtrot. So can we have your comments and collective marks, please, Tonis Moran?
Yes, Rose. I was quite amazed how lady in this English couple is responding. And their temporary suspension of the flight was really incredible also. So unfortunately for me and for Czech Republic, I have to award Czech Republic 1 point and England 2 points.
Thank you very much. Thank you. And now, Julie Earnshaw, what are your comments and combined marks for the lovely waltz?
Yes, in the waltz, I felt that the couple from the Czech Republic, unfortunately, very occasionally lost slight body contact, whereas I felt the couple from England danced with more togetherness. And collectively, we'd like to award the Czech Republic 1 point and England 2 points.
So, with our first two sections completed, the overall score is the Czech Republic 4 and England 8. Before we see our exciting junior competitors in action, let me introduce you now to our professional dancers appearing in our special cabaret spot. Ladies and gentlemen, here are Denny and Adele Tremblay with David Sycamore and Denise Weavers. Sensational routine from David Sycamore and Denise Weavers and Denny and Adele Tremblay. Well, now it's our junior section next, and although the competitors are only aged between 12 and 16, I'm sure they're already hoping to one day emulate the success of our professionals, who incidentally also started their careers in the junior ranks. The score, you remember, stands at the Czech Republic 4 and England 8. And so here to perform the pasodoble are Václav Kotásek and Petra Sobotková for the Czech Republic. And Ian Harvey and Elizabeth Francis representing England.
The Czech Republic's junior dancers, Václav Kotasek and Petra Sobotková, both 15, and they tell me they're enjoying the challenge of this their first venture abroad for a dancing competition. At home, they've been noted as one of their country's most promising junior couples. And Elizabeth Francis are 14 and 15, respectively. They've been partners just under a year, and that's been a busy year with practice sessions once or twice every week on top of the usual schoolwork. It makes for a pretty hectic schedule. It's paying off, though. They've recently won the UK Open Junior Modern Championship.
The Pasadoble. Performed with suitable panache by our junior competitors. So with the comments and combined marks, it's over to our neutral judge from Lithuania, Jurakė Novaišė.
Yes, we saw very good young couples. They danced pasodoble very well, both. But English couple produced better body lines and better character of pasodoble. And our collective marks, 2 points for England and 1 point for Czech.
England leads the contest tonight by 10 points to 5. And now for the final section of tonight's competition, the formation teams. This is a section in which 16 competitors incorporate a set number of rhythms into their routine and display some wonderfully imaginative choreography and movement. So first on the floor, please welcome the Czech Republic formation team.
Salam and good evening to you, worthy friend.
From the Czech town of Ostrava comes this team, very much at the top of the tree in their country. With this very routine, they've recently won their 20th consecutive Czech championship. This summer, they competed in Blackpool at the Open British Championship and finished second in the Latin formation section.
Gotta keep one jump ahead of the bread line, one swing ahead of the sort. I steal all what I can afford. That's everything. One jump ahead of the moment, that's all, and that's no joke. These guys don't appreciate I'm broke. Gotta face the facts. You're my only friend, Abu. One jump ahead of the Rockies, one hop ahead of the hike. One trick ahead of disaster. They're quick, but I'm much faster. Better throw my hand in, wish me happy landing. All I gotta do is jump.
I can open your eyes, take you wonder by wonder, over sideways and under.
Czech Republic formation team. Now on the floor, ready to get underway, is our second team this evening. And remember, a maximum of 6 points can be awarded in the formation section. So please welcome the team representing England, the Penge Latin Formation Team.
The figure you saw at the side of the floor there, clutching the team's mascot, is one of the reserves. All formation teams have them, warmed up and ready to go in case of a mishap. At this year's Open British Latin Formation Championship, the Penge team finished third, just behind their opponents in tonight's programme, the Czech Republic team. Thank you.
Latin formation team representing England. And so with the overall score standing at the Czech Republic 5 and England 10, let's join our judges for the final scores of the evening. And so may we have your comments and your marks, please, Tony Zmoran.
Yes, Rose. For a requirement of quality formations, you need really exactness and clarity, lines and pictures, and dynamic and speed, they changing. And for achievement of this assessment, you really need good team. And for my opinion, this good one, or better one tonight, was Czech Republic. So Czech Republic 2 points, England 1 point.
Thank you. And now, I'm sure
you're marked. But I felt that both teams danced with terrific expression and feeling. But this evening, I did feel that the team from the Czech Republic had more speed in their routine, and I award them 2 points and England 1 point.
And now our final mark of the evening, Jiraka Novajša, he's our neutral judge.
Yeah, I like two teams, English and Czech team, but Czech team produced fantastic connection between music and movement, and they were very dynamic. And I marked 2 points for Czechs and 1 point for England.
So the Czech Republic win tonight's formation team section, resulting in an overall final score of the Czech Republic 11 and England 13. So it's England who have won a place in the Come Dancing final against the winners of our Group B countries who start to compete next week in our international contest for the Marshall Amplification Trophy. I do hope you'll join us then when Sweden compete against Scotland. In the meantime, thank you for the pleasure of your company, ladies and gentlemen, and from all of us here at Bournemouth, a very good night.
Gentlemen, your host for Come Dancing, Rose Marie Ford.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Come Dancing here at Bournemouth. Tonight is the start of the Group B competition in our international series featuring Europe's top amateur dancers who are competing for the Marshall Amplification Trophy. This evening we're especially proud to be able to welcome on Come Dancing for the first time the team from Sweden. And to oppose them, one of the four United Kingdom teams taking part in the competition. Please welcome the team from Scotland. We open our contest with the vivacious Latin section, and to represent Sweden in the cha-cha-cha, here are Dermot Preminger and Diana Carlson. And for Scotland, let's welcome Alan Davis and Gillian Hackett. Charles Nove is ready with all the competitors' details, and waiting to give the downbeat to our great orchestra is our musical director, Andy Ross.
You remember
If you're thinking the name Dermot Clemenger doesn't sound very Swedish, you'd be right. Deanna Carlson is Swedish, all right, but Dermot's an Irishman. He moved to Sweden in 1993 to join Deanna, though they've since moved to Britain to be near the practice and training facilities they need. Deanna was Swedish Latin champion with her previous partner. Together, she and Dermot have won that title 3 years running. Scottish opposition comes in the form of Alan Davis and Gillian Hackett, a partnership of 18 months. Alan is 25, Gillian's 22, and they both represent Scotland in world and European competitions. Closer to home, they finished just outside the final six at the closed British Championship.
Wind and Fire in the late 70s, and rearranged this year by Andy Ross as the Cha-Cha-Cha. We continue now with the Paso Doble. This dance was originally performed to the music of the bullfight. The man depicts the artistry of the matador and his partner the flowing movements of the cape. So here competing for Sweden are Stefan Boström and Wasa Westin. Whilst for Scotland, let's welcome Mark Robertson and Leslie Tom.
Stefan Boström is 20 and a former Swedish youth champion. Asha Westin is 25 and she danced as a junior before having an 8-year break. She restarted her dancing career 1 year ago when she teamed up with Stefan. They won the Norway Christmas Cup and the Oslo Open last year, and they're now second placed in Sweden's amateur Latin ranks. Robertson and Leslie Tom are 19 and 22. Leslie's danced for the Scottish team many times before with her previous partner, an Australian gent who's now headed back home. Mark teamed up with Leslie a year ago. He's a former world junior champion. Together, they've become Scotland's Latin champions.
So now let me introduce you to our panel of judges. With us tonight, our Norwegian judge, who's competed for the last 20 years, winning 19 medals in both European and worldwide championships in formation dancing, which he now coaches, Arild Vestby. Our second second judge tonight is an international dance teacher and adjudicator, and is also no stranger to Come Dancing this year, from the Czech Republic, Tony Zmoran. And finally tonight, from Poland, and acting as our neutral judge, a former modern dancing champion. He competed worldwide for over 25 years and is now a professional adjudicator, Andriy Jakubowski. The first dance tonight in our Latin section was the cha-cha-cha, so can we please have your comments and your collective marks, Ariel Vespi.
For the cha-cha, it was two brilliant couples. It was very difficult for us to make a clear decision here. So what we said was for Scotland, 2 points, and from Sweden, 2 points. Split decision.
Thank you very much. And now, Tony Zmoran, can we have your comments or collective marks for the Paso Doble?
Yes, Rose. The Paso Doble, both couples produced wonderful performance. And we fear all three and collect decision that some way Scottish couple use much better depth and use better character of the Paso Doble. So total result is Scotland 2 points, Sweden 1 point.
Thank you. So after the Latin section, Sweden have 3 and Scotland have 4. Now it's the turn of the modern competitors with their 2 dances. Andy Ross turns to the Johnny Mercer songbook with Day In, Day Out to accompany our quick-step competitors, who are Stefan Azov and Frida Bjerström for Sweden. And for Scotland, here are Paul Burbage and Lisa Newlands.
And Frida Bergström, 2 students. He studies electronics, she's reading law. They're both 20 and they've been partners for 5 years. They were junior champions in 1991 and 92, the Swedish amateur 10 dance champions of 1993, and last year they became their country's amateur modern title holders. Burbage is 26, and his partner for almost a year has been Lisa Newlands. She's 24 and a Canadian from Toronto. She moved to this country 3 years ago for better dancing opportunities. At home, Lisa was a successful 10 dancer. Together, Paul and Lisa were recently runners-up in the Scottish Open competition.
To the grace and elegance of the Viennese waltz. And here to compete for Sweden are Klaus Woodstock and Mia Orman Liljeberg. Whilst representing Scotland, let's meet Stuart and Andrea Nairn.
I saw the light on the night that I passed by her window.
Klaus Woodstock is 24, and his partner for the last 4 years has been Mia Orman Liljeberg. They are former holders of the Swedish Modern Championship, and they've reached the semi-final stage of this year's UK Championship and the UK Rising Star competition.
As she deceived me, I watched them went out of my mind. My, 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 my,
Scotland represented by Stuart and Andrea Nairn, who are brother and sister, aged 19 and 15. In just under a year of dance partnership, they've competed in Italy and in Iceland, where they finished third in the Open Modern competition. They were runners-up in the All England Youth Modern Championship.
Time once again to join our panel of judges for those all-important marks. The first of our two modern dances tonight was that fabulous quick step. So can we have your comments and collective marks, please, Ariel Vestby?
Yes, the quick step was not so easy for us. We had a discussion before we made a final decision, and we finally said 2 points to Sweden and one to Scotland.
Viennese waltz, Tony Zmoran.
Yes, well, it is not quite easy spinning 2 minutes with partner, 60 bar per minute, three steps per bar, and still keep calmness and togetherness. And this task managed better Swedish couples, so Sweden 2 points, Scotland 1 point.
Sections completed, the overall score is Sweden 7 and Scotland 6. Before we see our exciting junior competitors in action, let me introduce you to our professional cabaret artists. Together with Denny and Adele Tremblay, they gave us some superb routines in earlier programs, but tonight they return to us as a solo couple. Ladies and gentlemen, David Sycamore and Denise Weavers.
Thank you.
What a stunning interpretation of The Matador and His Cape from David Sycamore and Denise Weavers. Well, next to take the floor are the junior competitors, aged between 12 and 16. Now, it's worth pointing out that David and Denise were also competing at this age and later, of course, became professional champions. So, with the score standing at Sweden 7 and Scotland 6, let's meet the juniors. And competing for Sweden, here are Göran Martinsson and Piotr Friedemann. And for Scotland, please welcome Christopher Lambert and Michelle Thompson.
Göran Martinsson and Piotr Friedemann are both 15, though Göran will be 16 in a matter of days. They've been dancing together for 6 of their years, and they've won their country's junior 10-dance championship. Juniors, somewhat younger. Christopher Lambert is 13, Michelle Thompson is 12. They're both at school in Edinburgh. They started dancing together nearly 3 years ago, tackling both modern and Latin styles, and they're Scotland's junior 10-dance champions.
Dancing to that lovely song, June. Our panel of judges were watching the dancers very closely. So, with the comments and combined marks, it's over to our neutral judge, Andriy Yakubovsky.
Tonight, both young couples present us good basic figures in waltz. Finally, we prefer good pictures presented by couples from Sweden. Finally, we give 2 points to Sweden and 1 point to Scotland.
Thank you. And so, after 3 sections, Sweden lead tonight's contest by 9 points to 7. Now we come to the last section, the formation teams. Now, formation dancing originated in Britain and was described as shadow dancing when London's Astoria Ballroom presented the first ever display in 1932. And remember, there are a maximum of 6 points to be awarded, so everything rests on this final section. First on the floor to represent Sweden, please welcome the Göteborgs Formation Team.
Thank you.
Dancing is Sweden's fastest growing sport, but surprisingly there was no international style formation dancing until 2 years ago, and this is the team that started it all off. The inspiration? Well, a Swedish dance couple came to Britain on a visit and were invited to watch the Penge Latin team practice and perform. They were bowled over and went home intent on bringing formation dancing to Sweden. They did, and it certainly caught on.
Eu que quero até o fim, sou toda pra você. Quero que viva só para mim. E que tu vayas por donde eu vaya. Para que minha alma se anomasse de ti. Deixa-me com frenesi. Deixa-me com frenesi. Deixa-me com frenesi. Deixa-me com.
Formation team. The Scottish team are all ready to start, so let's meet the Harris formation team.
We've seen this team, trained by Sammy and Anne Harris, a good few times before on Come Dancing. Since their last visit here, they've been joined by one new girl, and the supporters club has grown by at least four, as four of the team members have produced babies in the last year or so. They took part in the recent Open British Championship and reached the final.
Come on, shake your body, baby, do the conga. Tony, can't control yourself any longer.
Representing Scotland. And so with the overall score standing very close, with Sweden on 9 and Scotland on 7, let's see what the outcome will be as we return to our judges for their final marks. And firstly to Arvil Vestby.
To judge formation dancing, it's a lot of things that you have to look at. You have to look at the combination of moving and picture and the music and for sure the technique. And when you put all these things together, my decision was 2 points for Sweden and 1 for Scotland.
Thank you very much. Now Tony's Moran.
Well, I feel that one of these formations has much higher difficulty in choreography. They had much better costumes, they used much better music, and also interpretation of the individual dance is much higher. So I also awarding Sweden 2 points, Scotland 1 point.
Neutral judge, Andriy Yapakovsky.
Formation from Sweden present us much interesting choreography, much good dancing all by all the dancers. I give 2 points for Sweden formation, 1 point for Scotland.
Formation team section, resulting in an overall final score of Sweden 15 and Scotland 10. So Sweden go through to the next round of the Come Dancing International Competition. Competing for the Marshall Amplification Trophy next week will be the team from Poland and once again the team from the Czech Republic. So I do hope you'll make a date to come dancing with us here at Bournemouth. Until then, we wish you a very good night.
A dark film thriller coming next on BBC One as a wealthy heiress falls into twisted company, the Grissom Gang.
Ladies and gentlemen, your host for Come Dancing, Rosemary Ford.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Come Dancing here at the International Centre in Bournemouth. Tonight, two more of Europe's best amateur dance teams compete for the Marshall Amplification Trophy. And it's a very warm welcome to the country who are the reigning Come Dancing international champions. They are, of course, the team from Holland. To oppose the champions and dancing for the first time in this competition, we're proud to welcome the team from Germany. The Latin section and the jive get the evening off to an exciting start. And stepping out for Holland, it's Lee Hunter and Sonja Parmantier. And jiving for Germany, it's Dirk Reiser and Dorothy Zumpken. With me to give you all the facts and figures is our commentator, Charles Nove. And on stage, leading our great orchestra, the maestro himself, Andy Ross.
And Sonja Parmantier both work in a big dance studio in Amersfoort. For Lee, it's quite a change from his hometown of Sheffield, which he left 4 years ago to move to Holland in pursuit of greater dancing glory. He tells me his Dutch is now fluent, but he has the odd bit of difficulty remembering English. Lee and Sonja finished third in this year's Netherlands Amateur Championship. And Dorothy Zumpken for Germany. He's 26, she's 25, and they're both students. They dance both Latin and modern, and their expertise won them the West German 10 Dance Championship last year. They're Germany's second-ranked Latin couple.
The old Neil Sedaka hit, Calendar Girl, arranged as a jive. Next tonight, the drum and poise of the Paso Doble is the second of our two Latin dances. And here to compete for Holland are Marcel Kaiser and Patricia de Bult. Representing Germany, it's Oliver Goylan and Tanja Beitz.
Rotterdam, Marcel Kaiser and Patricia de Bult. He's 25, she's 22, and they've been dance partners for 2 years. They've reached the finals of the Dutch Championships, and they've won the North of Holland Latin title. Oliver Goylan is 27. His partner for the last 5 years has been Tanja Beitz, who's 23. They reached the final six at the German 10 Dance Championship and a place in the finals too at Germany's Latin and Modern Ranking competitions. Those are the contests which decide which dancers get to represent their country in competitions abroad.
Section of tonight's competition. It's time now to meet our judges for those all-important marks. And here to give their expert opinion, please welcome from Holland, a former Latin dance Dutch champion, now professional trainer, Henny Fieberink. From Germany, a former world champion. He is well known in this country for winning the British Championships twice. Horst Beer. And finally, acting as our neutral judge from Norway, a winner of many medals over the last 20 years in competition, Arel Vestby. The Latin section began with the jive, so for the comments and combined marks, it's over to Henny Fieberink.
Well, I thought it was a very close come, these two couples. I mean, we had to look very sharp, but we three decided to give two marks to Germany and one to Holland.
Thank you. And for the marks in the Paso Doble, Horst Beer.
Yeah, both couples did a very good performance, and also there we decided 2 points for Germany and one for Holland.
Thank you very much. Thank you. So, Germany are the winners of the Latin section by 4-2. We move on now to the modern section and the waltz, which in Regency times was quoted as being dizzying and intoxicating. And believe it or not, parents were warned that their unmarried daughters might lose control. However, I'm sure perfectly in control tonight are Tony and Anita Dockman, representing Holland, whilst competing for Germany, it's Wolfgang Krüppel and Corina Zuvelda.
Brother and sister, aged 25 and 26. At home, they won the Dutch Modern Championship no less than 7 times, while their away matches have included the European 10 Dance Competition, in which they were placed second.
When can I touch you? When can I
Wolfgang Krüppel is 28, Corinna Zufelder is 25, and their partnership is 8 years old. Their most recent competition achievement, taking the West German Amateur Modern Championship.
Lovely number with a lovely title, Weekend in New England, chosen by Andy Ross to accompany our competitors for the first modern dance. Well, to complete the second section of tonight's competition, we move away from the elegant sweep of the waltz to the staccato action of the tango. And here to dance for Holland are Henk Peter Voss and Anita Langford. And to represent Germany, Stefan Wenzel and Sandra Beer.
Another Anglo-Dutch partnership. Henk Peter Voss and Anita Langford. It's 3 years now since Anita left her hometown of Portsmouth and moved to Holland to join forces with Henk. Together, they've won the North of Holland Modern title, and at this year's Netherlands Amateur Modern Championships, they were runners-up. Stefan Wenzel is a student, aged 22. Sandra Byrne is a banker, she's 23. They've been partners for 4 years, and in the German world ranking competition, they reached the final six. As for last year's German Masters, they won the modern section.
Modern section to a close. You remember that Germany are the early leaders, but that all might change now as we turn again to our judges. And for the comments and combined marks for that lovely waltz, it's over to Henny Fieberink.
Yeah, it was, I thought, beautiful music, and the couples did very good on this music, and we decided to mark 2 marks for Holland, 1 for Germany.
Thank you. And for the marks of tango, Horst
Bier. Yeah, the tango interpretation from both couples were very good, but also there we decided 2 points for Holland and 1 for Germany.
Thank you very much. So Holland win the modern section, and those marks mean that after 2 sections, Holland and Germany both have 6 points. We're going to take a break from the competition now and welcome back some familiar faces to Come Dancing. In the past, we've seen many a winning routine from our next performers, but earlier this year, they decided to take the plunge and turn professional. So it's a great pleasure to welcome back John Burns and Jane Littleton.
Got to find those extra cups to fill. They've got an awful lot of coffee in Brazil. You can't get cherry soda, for they cannot sell the quota. And the way things are, I think they never will. They've got a zillion tons of coffee in Brazil. No tea or tomato juice, you will see. No potato juice, 'cause the plant is down and Santa's all say no, no, no. A politician's daughter was accused of drinking water and must find a great big $50 bill. They've got an awful lot of coffee in Brazil. No, 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 a politician's daughter was accused of drinking water and was fined a great big $50 bill. They've got an awful lot of coffee. They've got an awful lot of coffee. They've got an awful lot of coffee down in home.
And of course, we wish them all the luck and success in the world within the professional ranks. Back to the competition, and next in the spotlight, the 12 to 16-year-old junior performers who'll be hoping one day, I'm sure, to follow in the footsteps of John and Jane. With the scores standing at Holland 6 and Germany 6, the pressure really is on. So let's meet our quick-steppers, who are Arjen Moisier and Monique Bloek-Merlin for Holland. And representing Germany, here are Albert and Karim Buhl.
Arjen Moisier and Monique Bloek-Merlin are the Dutch youth champions in both modern and Latin, and they were the second-placed couple in the Benelux Youth Championship. He's 14, she's 13, and they're both from The Hague.
Mm-hmm.
Germany's junior couple, Adelbert and Karin Bühl, aged 16 and 14, respectively. They're brother and sister, and in their 5 years of dancing partnership, they've been runners-up in the under-16 Latin section of the German Masters competition, and they've won the under-16 modern section.
The late Henry Mancini's theme to the film of the same name, which starred Cary Grant and Audrey Hepburn. And to assess those junior stars, it's over to our panel of judges. And acting as their spokesperson is the neutral judge. So can we have your comments and combined marks, Ariel Vespi?
Yes, it's very difficult to split these young couples. We all agree that it was two couples with a lot of speed and a lot of action on the floor, really nice moving. In this fast dance. Our final decision is 2 points for Germany and 2 points for Holland.
Thank you, and so after three sections, the scores are still equal, with both Holland and Germany on 8 points. And so to our last section tonight, and with a maximum of 6 points available, there's added pressure to these competitors in the formation teams. Now, formation dancing is very popular on the continent, and tonight two of the best teams in Europe are competing. So let's welcome the Vida Formation Team.
The Vida Formation Team have been together around 2 years. Their average age is 20, and they're the Dutch formation champions. Champions or not, you can still get your dress caught in your shoe. It's how you recover that counts. The 1995 European Formation Competition was held in this team's hometown, Doetinchem, in the east of Holland, and they finished fourth.
Thank you.
work all day. Out in the sun they slave away. Why will be voting full time to floating under the sea?
Next on the floor tonight, the team that won the World Formation Championships in Dresden last year. Please welcome the TSG Bremerhaven Formation Team.
Señoras y señores, ahora les presentamos Color Latino.
Formation teams don't come much more formidable than this one. Watch the accuracy of their lines as they bring us Color Latino, the colors of Latin, and you'll see why. The team ranges in age from 19 to 29, and they've won the German National Championship 14 times, the European title 5 times, and the World Formation Championship no less than 10 times. Most recently, as Rosemary mentioned, at Dresden in December last year.
The TSG Bremerhaven Formation Team. I'm sure you'll agree those were two fabulous routines, but which was the winning performance and why? We're really eager to find out, so let's ask our panel of judges first for his comments and marks, Henny Fiebering.
I hope everybody can see how nice formation dancing is, and I'm very pleased that these two teams were here tonight, but there's only one Bremerhaven, so it's two marks to Bremerhaven and one for Fida.
Thank you very much. And now Horsebier.
Those teams did a very good show, but also I think two marks for Germany, one for Holland.
And now the final marks from our neutral judge, Adel Vesby.
Yes, it's like this, that both these teams is representing the countries in international championships. But still, FIDE has a quite young team, they are working hard. Bremerhaven is already world class, so two points for Germany and one for Holland.
So Germany win tonight's formation team section, resulting in an overall final score of Holland 11, Germany 14. So it's Germany who go through to the Group B semi-final of Come Dancing International Contest for the Marshall Amplification Trophy. Thank you for being with us tonight, and on behalf of Charles Nove, Andy Ross, and all of us here at Bournemouth, we hope you can come dancing with us again next week when Sweden competes against Poland. Until then, a very good night.